All right, welcome to the last round. Clearly not a mulligan. In case you guys were wondering what the dream looked like, this is pretty darn close. We're actually going to lead with Talisman here, as opposed to Dimir Signet. Wow. Mostly to pay for days if he were to force us. Or if he were to daze us on his turn. Like if he had a turn one show and tell or something. And we go force of will and he goes daze. Talisman lets us pay for it, whereas Dimir Signet does not. I'm actually a little perplexed about this. I think this means that he has a wasteland in hand. Which we're okay with. Not super okay. This is really weird. The force of will. I just don't want to lose Tezzeret because it's our only action. And we have a non-wasteable land, so I think we'll be okay. I think. If he spends his turn wasting us, we're going to have, like, another turn of him not having any pressure to... Yep. Darks look sure, sure. Ideally, when I cast Force of Will, I would like to have another blue card to pitch than this Tezzeret. This Tezzeret seems important. Seems like a pretty good card. So I'm not going to play the Delta yet. So that one can get stifled. He can either Spell Snare or Spell Pierce Dimir Signet. I'm just going to let that happen. Or yes, even days. But he didn't play a one drop last turn, so that makes me think he doesn't have a one drop this turn. Ponder makes a lot of sense. And right now we're a mana away from either Tezzeret or Damnation, which is a pretty decent place to be. Our best draw is Baleful Strix. I won't say no to having a turn to crack Delta without Stifle up, though. And that might be why he didn't ponder last turn. And then when we didn't play a fetch, he was like, okay, maybe he's just not going to play anything that I can do this to. Plays Tarmogoyf, I say sure. Ancient Tomb. Okay, that's a really good one. I'm just going to pass the turn. He's going to hit us with Tarmogoyf and then probably play another threat. Probably a second Tarmogoyf. It was kind of awkward for him to play his land before pondering. Maybe that implies he has a bolt in hand, if he thinks that he needs to leave up a red. Because maybe Ponder finds a wasteland that he wants to play. Yep, there's the other threat. And now I feel pretty comfortable damnationing his board. I'm not going to expose the Baleful Strix to daze. In fact, I'm not even going to tap this Ancient Tomb unless he makes me. It would be basically him spending a Spell Pierce on a card, I guess. Or a Shock, which isn't worth it when I'm at 13 life. And then next turn, we've got some options. Not really sure which of these I value more. If I have to Force a Will something here. But he's not going to make me. Jace. Oh, that's sweet. I think I run it out and Fate Seal him. Like this. And then we can hopefully just deny him threats. We've already seen two Strixes from him, so I don't really mind. I am considering Force of Willing this Brainstorm, though. I mean, we've already seen two Dazes from him. He's pitched one, he's already played one, so I don't really mind running it into it when it's this card that isn't vital. The reason I'm considering Force of Willing the Brainstorm is because we've already given him a Volcanic Island on top of his library, and if we Force of Will this, we're more likely to just lock him out of the game. Yeah, I'm just going to do that. Okay, and he has double Lightning Bolt to take care of Jace. Which leaves us at some kind of awkward parity, only we just drew Tezzeret, so... And he's drawing Volcanic Island. So how about that parody? How about them apples? He's pausing on his upkeep. I don't know what that means. At 10 life, it's actually kind of nice that he had to use double bolts to kill my Jace. And we got value out of that information by leaving a card on top. Obviously, I'm really happy that I drew Tezzeret. I don't particularly like making Baleful Strix a 5/5. I think I would rather uptick Tezzeret. Maybe shouldn't have played this Polluted Delta first. In case I found a Seed of the Synod off the Tezzeret. Upticking Tezzeret protects it from Bolt, of course, so you'd need to have two Bolts to answer it. Ratchet Bomb's actually a pretty good card against him. And I'm not going to cast it yet. I'm just going to attack him for one and ship turn. I don't want to have to shock myself to play it. If he untaps and plays a threat, we can always leave Baleful Strix back. Or turn the Ratchet Bomb into a 5/5, you know, any number of things. No need to take pain. Odds are that the pain won't matter, since we're still at 10. However, who knows, maybe he's playing a version with like a couple Chain Lightnings in it, and there's still four cards in his deck that can dome us. There's no reason to run ourselves into that. We could Ultimate Tezzeret for 6, but I don't really like that. I'm going to tick it up one more time. Baleful Strix, perfect. Which we're going to play first. With that ability on the stack, we're actually going to crack Delta. Because we're going to play Delta anyway this turn, so the thinning kind of matters. Playing Thopter Foundry is pretty good. I was going to go Talisman into Ratchet Bomb, but now I think I just go Thopter Foundry with a mana up. And that should just win us the game if this resolves. He could spell snare it, but that's about it. And the reason we're doing this instead of playing these two cards is, again, he could have triple Lightning Bolt type effect, which playing the Thopter Foundry plays around. So it is not cracking the fetch land, but I think if we didn't draw Thopter Foundry, we would have just played both of these. Okay, he just packed it in. He was like, enough of this. Enough of this garbage. I'm sick of this, and I'm sick of you too, Caleb Durward. Rah! Then he shook his fist at me all menacing. Yeah, so all of these are coming in, and we're gonna get these. Like if you recall, we ended up Force of Willing a Brainstorm that game, and that was like... I was ecstatic. That's a terrific use of Force of Will in this matchup. So all this crap's coming in. The dresses are going to protect my hand when I don't have a chalice in play. And if I have a chalice in play, I've already won the game. So I'm pretty happy with duress. It's one of the reasons Talisman is kind of better sometimes. It's because you can go turn one Talisman off of an Ancient Tomb and duress them, and then untap and play a planeswalker, which is a very nice curve. But he's already shown that he's willing to force of will a mana rock, so who knows if that would even happen. Still need to make one cut. Oh, Karn. This is the most awkward matchup for Karn ever. Rorqual Engine's really good in this matchup, but I don't have any in this list, just the Thopters. I guess Thopter Foundry's also insane. It turns random mana rocks into blockers for Tarmogoyf, that sort of thing. Until I can find a sword. Yeah, I like this. This is good. Vendilion Click just costs too much. It's not worth it. Costs too much to not stabilize the board against a pair of Goyfs. Damnation was really good last game. It made the Miser seem really worth it.